Welcome students, in this lecture we will see creation of a 3D model by using pattern pocket in part design. So let's start. Now here we have a 3D model here, so we will develop this 3D model in CATIA software. So for creating this 3D model, first of all we need to understand from which face we can create this particular model. So for creating this particular model, this right face is perfect for creating this kind of shape. So we will start from the right face. So go for sketch. Select the right plane. So you will be entering into Sketcher. First of all, we have to create this L shape, which is having a value of length of 145. Height of 90, this is 35 and this is 25. So we will take profile by selecting here. I will pick over here. I will click on this. So by mistake I got some cross lines here and here. So I can rectify by selecting this. I will go for constraint dialog box and make it horizontal. Again select this. I will go for constraint dialog box. We will make it vertical. So double click on this constraint dialog box. This complete length we will take as 145 and this complete height as 90. This is 35. This is 25. So now we have to exit from here. The complete length of this particular model is around 72. So I will select here pad. So if I am using mirror extend means 72 means I will take 36 for getting complete 72. This side 36 and this side 36. And you have to give okay. Now we also having a cut at bottom side. So we need to select this face. Go for sketch. Just take a rectangle. Click on this face and here. If you want to contact this end and this end and this end and this end, double click on constraints. Select this and this. Right click. Coincidence. Select this and this. Don't click on the screen, just give right click and coincidence. Length of this cut is 70 and height of this cut is 5. This should be, double click on this, should be 70. Select this and it should be 5. And again, exit workbench. And depth of the cut is around 50. Select the pocket command and give value as 50 and apply preview and give OK. So like this you can make a cut at this location. Next cut we have on this face. Go for sketch. Select the face. A big circle we have of around 30 radius. Select a circle exactly at center. Assign value from here, from 30 radius means I will take 60 diameter. From the center to the end we are having a height of some 45. Select this, from this location to this location, some double click on this 45. We are also having a cut at this side. So for that we will be taking a rectangle, centered rectangle. Exactly from this center point. Here, but we need to coincide this end and this end. Double click on this. This to this. Right click. Coincidence. And height of this is around some he has mentioned from here to here we have to choose as 24. So select this, and this we need to give as 24. And remaining part we need to trim. So we will go for operation toolbar, double click on this. We will remove this and remove this, and we will remove this. So this kind of shape we will get, and exit. So this depth is around 10. Go for pocket and assign value as 10 and give OK. So you will get this kind of cut. But we have one more cut inside a hole of 24 dia. Again, go for sketch on this face. You have to select this face. So go for circle, click on the circle, go for constraint, select on this, assign some value as around 24. So actually it is not exactly on center, so we will remove this. Select this and assign value of some 24. So actually we need concentricity between this circle and this arc and this arc. So we have a constraint over here. Select this and this. If I want to match center of this arc and this circle, don't click on the screen, just give right click. We have concentricity and go for exit workbench. You may go for pocket and you change the reverse direction. How much you need, you can assign. I need till last end I need, so you may give OK. So like this we will be getting hole over here. We have one more hole over here, one slot is available at this location on this face. Go for sketch, select the face. We will be taking a rectangle, a centered rectangle like this. And we need require a circle over here. For that we will be choosing circle. If you want to trim this part, double click on this trim, remove this and remove. We will remove this entire object. We will use here this rectangle. Double click on this. We will remove this line. We will make a tangency between this and this. Select this, control this. Go for constraint dialog box, because there is no tangency between this circle and this. We will make it coincide by selecting this and this, right click, coincidence, and this should be 24. And the distance between these two, this also 24. Select this and this, and this radius is 12. So it's already 24. We can't assign because it is taking as over constraint. The length of this object is around 50 from this center to the end. I will go for constraint. Select this. This. Double click on this. Some around 50. And go for exit workbench. And go for pocket. Select this sketch, till last we need apply OK. So like this we can create the slot for this particular model. In next lecture we will see how to use shaft and groove in part design. Thank you.